Can you hear me now?
Yeah, loud and clear, and we can see the slides. If you go full screen, okay. Fantastic, thank you.
Okay, well, hello, I'm Vasilis Tsiligiannis. I have been responsible for the specification and implementation of the software-defined radio testbed. Let's start with explaining what is an SDR testbed. An SDR testbed is a tool, actually, for the research and development of SDR-based satellite communication systems. It allows early experimentation and testing of new algorithms and configurations. The objective of this project was to physically implement such a testbed and also make it available to software-defined radio developers and researchers. During the design, the principle that we had was based on a commercial off-the-shelf hardware. It should use as much as possible free or completely free and open source software and technologies. And being itself fully open source, it is freely and publicly available as a service to the open source SDR community. This is the picture of what has been assembled, part of what has been assembled. We started with assembling a powerful computer, off the shelf computer, based on the AMD Ryzen 7 processor. And attached on it, there were various SDR devices through programmable and fixed RF components, cables, attenuators, etc. This is a hardware block diagram of the testbed. The SDR devices and the programmable switch, as well as the attenuator, are all connected through either USB hub of the host or an Ethernet switch leading to the Ethernet port of the computer host. All of these are controlled by the Ethernet interface, mostly through SCPI, the programmable switches and attenuators, and the SDR devices are directly controlled by GNU Radio. So the computer host controls both the devices and transmits and receives the data for the experiments from the SDR devices. The SDR devices that are currently attached to the SDR testbed are a Netus Research USRP B200 Mini, and Lime SDR Mini, the AirSpy R2, the analog devices Pluto SDR, and the RTL SDR V3. Of course, we can reconfigure the testbed and add more SDR devices. We have some ports that are unused, or even change the configuration and move other devices to the TX path or the RX path. This is the programmable RF switch. It is actually a dual SP40 switch made by Mini Circuits. And it has as we will see later, it has some specific characteristics that help us not damage the SDR devices in case of accidental transmission. This is the SDR testbed programmable attenuator. This is a 90 dB attenuator. It has a resolution of 0.25 dB, again made by Mini Circuits. Both the attenuator and the switch that we saw previously are controlled via Ethernet through the SCPI protocol. Here we can see a connection diagram of the programmable RF switch. As you can see, there are actually two switches. It's a dual switch, and for each switch, only one SDR device can be selected. When specifying the experiment, you always select a pair of devices from either switch, and they are selected. The other ports are all connected to the 50 ohm load. So, in case of accidental misconfiguration and accidental transmission from the other SDR devices, the devices will not be damaged. The two switches are connected through two attenuators. One is a fixed attenuator, and while the other is programmable, as we saw previously. The fixed attenuator is there so that it's a 20 dB attenuator, and it's there so to ensure that the TX signal cannot cause any damage to the receiving devices. Oops, what happened here? Sorry. Uh, About the software that we used, these are the components that we have been based on. The base host system is a CentOS Linux operating system. And it is provisioned, installed, all the software is installed with Ansible. There are specific roles developed for the testbed. Then we have used the technology of GitLab CI to as a job server, let's say. All of these are running inside the Docker containers. Not the GitLab CI, but the GNU Radio Drupal framework that we use for testing are running inside the Docker containers. So these are the technologies we will see later in more detail. The testbed is fully automatically provisioned from a CentOS minimal installation, a bare CentOS minimal installation, using Ansible. Basically, two roles were developed, one for Docker, for deploying Docker inside the CentOS minimal installation, and one for making the system GitLab CI runner. All of these are configured through configuration variables of Ansible, as you can see below. And on the right, you can see the result, which is from the GitLab user interface. You can see that the SDR testbed runner is registered and waiting for receiving jobs. This is the software block diagram. As you can see here, there is the GitLab CI top left, where almost everything starts. An experiment can be defined using GitLab and creating a merge request and having all the data and the scenario available either in Git or Git LFS. The GitLab CI runner will, if it is available, it will pull the job and the data and will spawn a Docker container. The Docker container has an entry point to the robot framework. The robot framework is a testing framework that is used for acceptance-driven testing. The robot framework will first configure the testbed, meaning it will put the switches to the correct position and also configure the attenuator. And then it will spawn the GNU Radio or one GNU Radio process or multiple GNU Radio processes, usually two, one for the TX and one for the RX. And wait for the results. Once the results the experiment is over, the results will be pulled. It will be fed to the GitLab CI runner and uploaded to GitLab CI job artifact storage through GitLab CI service. Some challenges that we have during the development of the SDR testbed was the USB device access. It is very difficult to access the USB host devices within the container. Fortunately, recently there was some development in the Docker engine that allowed to use an option, the device cgroup rule. This allowed to have access to the USB devices inside the container without having to run the container as a privileged container, which, as you might guess, would be a security issue. Another issue that we have that we have not successfully solved is that the SDR devices, the SDR USB devices, often stall. Yeah, and this requires to make them unstall. It requires a power reset. Usually, it's not enough to just reset the device, and it requires power reset. So we have created a script that will reset the devices at the start of every experiment. Future challenges will be scalability, because now we have a single SDR testbed and it can serve only one experiment at a time. There are two options for that. One is to scale up, so create multiple GitLab CI runners on the same host, meaning multiple switches, multiple attenuators, etc. And the other solution is to scale out into multiple hosts with a single GitLab CI runners. That might, if the hosts are powerful enough to run the GNU Radio the GNU Radio flow graphs, that might make us not need any switches, but only an attenuator, because the switches are the main cost of the hardware cost of the SDR testbed. Other challenges are the configurability of the SDR device of the SDR testbed. As I said previously, although we have specifically selected some devices to be on the one side of the switch, the first switch, and the others on the other side of the switch, if we need to make, we don't have all the combination of RX and TX. So to increase the RX-TX combinations, there is a solution of daisy chaining our switches. It will cost more, but this is the only way for to avoid having to reconfigure the SDR testbed for any case that we need a different combination of TX and RX SDR devices. Another issue that we have encountered is the performance, and specifically the network upload bottleneck. Usually the experiments generate a large amount of IQ data. And right now, the SDR testbed is located in Hackerspace Athens, Greece, which is also the labs of Libre Space Foundation. And the upload is not adequate, I would say, to have it is a performance bottleneck, I would say. So if we had better network upload, it would be much faster and would give us better availability. Now, some application of the testbed. The testbed is there, but it has not been used extensively yet. One of the applications that we had in mind from the beginning of the implementation of the testbed was end-to-end testing of flow graphs. I mean, you make a new flow graph and you want to test if it's functioning correctly. Then you can create a scenario in a robot framework and upload it to the repository, which has the GitLab runner of SDR testbed, and execute it and get the results of accurate and see if it really functions as you want. This is the main application of the SDR testbed testing, and mostly end-to-end testing, like I'm saying here, that for Shadowlux client it would be very helpful to know that any change that we make, any release, is functional before it is released, and we can test that with the SDR testbed now. Another thing that we could see in the future is to repurpose the SDR testbed to be a hardware in the loop for hardware in the loop testing. Instead of using, we could attach a comms device on one of the ports of the testbed and use it for hardware in the loop testing. And because either if it's not an SDR, if it's a normal comms, it is the same for the software, as long as there are sufficient libraries to support in the robot framework to support this device. So we could see this testbed function as hardware in the loop testing in the future. I think I'm done. These are links and references to the things I've said, the GitLab CI documentation, a Docker image that we have created for the testbed specifically, that which contains all the necessary software, including GNU Radio, Robot Framework, etc. The Libre Space Foundation Archimble Playbook to provision an SDR testbed from scratch, not from CentOS Minimal. The last one, the testbed runners is a dummy repository that only contains the runners, so that we can monitor if they are functional or not. I think that's it. Any questions?
Thank you, Vasilis, for the presentation. We already have a couple of questions here on the chat. The first one from Bob around the mini circuit attenuator, and do we have any specifications and measurements for port isolation? I think we can post the data set
Yes.
On the chat. The second question by David is regarding the usage of CentOS and if it's somehow now a dead end.
Yeah.
After the latest developments on the CentOS world.
Yeah.
And that's if we plan to migrate.
Not yet, because we're based on CentOS 7 and it's still fortunately supported. But we should eventually migrate to 8, or not to 8, to the fork, the open source fork, eventually.
Okay. Another question about the usage of USB 2 or USB 3 for USRP?
It is USB 3.
So
all ports are USB 3, yeah. On this specific, we selected the specific motherboard of the testbed to be sufficient for the requirements that we have set in the beginning. So all ports are USB 3.
Cool. The next question from Derek is around if you have considered using this as a testbed for continuous integration testing on GRSOPI.
Yes, of course. Of course, we have considered it.
And then from Frank, would the testbed, possibly with some adaptations, allow distributed control of tests? For example, executing tests with changing power at multiple remote satellite uplinks and recording the bear at the local gateway. On-air testing.
The robot framework allows us to do on the fly changes on any component. I mean, it is not just you set the configuration and leave it like that. You can continuously change the attenuator levels, even change the switches while the experiment is running. So I guess that it should be possible. And I don't fully understand the multiple remote satellite comment, but maybe it's
something. Yeah, Vasilis, it would be almost having two test beds. My question is specifically about over the air testing. So I have a number of remote uplinks, let's say SDR transmit only. I want to play with the gain settings there, and at the gateway site, which is maybe far away, and there is a real satellite in between, I want to record a bit error rate and so on, and I want to control this testing in a proper way using your robot. So I have geographically separated things. Would that be possible?
No, not as it is now, but maybe it could be adapted to do that. Maybe because a robot framework has a concept of remote tests, but I haven't been experimenting with that, so I cannot promise anything. And you can connect from robot framework through SSH to any device and run your tests there. But I'm not. I can't answer for with confidence if it is possible or not right now.
Thanks.